This is the time of year when a lot of new cookbooks are released, and one of the best is the brand new edition of one of the most famous cookbooks ever from Good Housekeeping. Food director Susan Westmoreland joins me today with a preview. Good morning.
Morning, Carly. Nice to see you.
So I want to say, I believe this is one of the largest cookbooks I've ever seen. Tell us about the 2018 edition.
2018 edition, it is 1,200 triple-tested recipes, but along with that is all of what Good Housekeeping is really famous for, our expertise in all of the testing that we do in the different labs, from not just recipes, but any kind of kitchen equipment. I also work with the people who test everything from spatulas to stoves. So the intro chapters in the book reflect on what's the best knife, what do I look for when I'm buying a knife, what's, you know, how do I buy cookware, all kinds of things like that to help you navigate all the choices you have in your kitchen if you're a new cook or if you're just looking to update, or like what do I really need and what's nice to have, and oh, what is that thing that they're talking about? And you can kind of go in and look up what a microplane is or something like that. So that chapter is really, that was a really fun chapter to put together with all of our expertise. And then the other chapter that's all new is a pantry chapter that kind of takes setting up a pantry, all about food safety, all about, you know, all things like that. And then pantry recipes that, you know, we're kind of having a little bit of, as busy as we are, sometimes we love that DIY moment. So we have things like homemade ricotta and how to make your own Nutella, how to make some cordials and flavored vinegars, and then staple recipes that you can use a bunch of different ways. I'm going to show you this roasted tomatoes here that just like roast in a hot oven. They're grape tomatoes and they are delicious. They're due ahead. You can keep them for a couple of weeks and they're like on an appetizer platter with some grilled bread or some veggies, and also tossed with a pound of pasta for a really quick dinner. So that's like things like that, and this roasted red pepper dip, which you could roast your own peppers or use a jar of peppers, and it's got some toasted walnuts, a little bit of Middle Eastern flavor, delicious as a dip or spread, also delicious with grilled or roasted meat. You know, things like that where you can kind of play around with where you use things. I think we love that double duty kind of thing happening. Well, and then holiday time, you know, you want to have a showstopper. So this dessert is, we're taking cranberries and putting them in a sweet application. We've got some cinnamon in the filling, and then it's just delicious buttery vanilla layers and some whipped cream. All of that can be done ahead and just assembled morning of the party. So fun things like that.
Yeah, well, what's interesting is, you because know, I feel like there's so many people that are either gluten-free or they have different allergies, and it looks like your cookbook addresses that as well.
We do. We address gluten-free, and we also, like, there's a, you know, we're not vegetarians all the times, many of us, but we have, you know, meals during the week that we are vegetarian. So there's a whole chapter on vegetarian and grain, and then there's a whole separate vegetable chapter. This is from the vegetarian chapter, and it's, I love this, it's roasted cauliflower flatbreads, and you've got like an avocado mash, which is some lemon or lime juice, roasted cauliflower and chickpeas, and then some toasted pumpkin seeds, and it's really delicious. That's a great dinner or lunch, and also you could cut it into little wedges and have it as an appetizer, you know, for as part of a, you know, pass around thing. Really fun. So it's, I think, and then, you know, everybody loves a skillet thing. And this is a curry. It's a really simple curry with shrimp, and it's got, you know, spice in it. You could amp up the spice. So there's tips in the book. They want it spicier, add this or this. But this is a very, like, you know, family friendly, not too spicy, really easy to do.
All right. Well, I got to ask, where can we get this cookbook? Because I feel like this is a great holiday gift for a lot of people on our list this year.
It would be a great holiday gift. It's available wherever books are sold, and online on Amazon. And you know, and speaking of gifts, one more second, we've got like some hot and spicy nuts that would be a great hostess gift to make, and that's kind of, you know, those are in the pantry chapter too. So there's things to, there's giftable food in here as well as food to cook for your family. So,
it sounds like the encyclopedia of cookbooks. Thank you so much. We appreciate your time this
Thank
morning.
Thank you, Carly.
Happy
Thank
holidays.
You so much. Same to you.